Good morning. Please rise as you're able and face the rear of the sanctuary. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew, the 21st chapter. When they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethphage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this, 'The Lord needs them,' and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey, and on a colt, the foal of a donkey." The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put their coats on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heaven!" When he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." The Gospel of the Lord. But you can hold up your palms. Those of you at home, hold up your palm of your hand or hold up any branch or tree you have around the house. Let us pray. We praise you, O God, for redeeming the world through our Savior, Jesus Christ. Today he entered the holy city in triumph and was proclaimed Messiah and King by those who spread garments and branches along his way. Bless these palms and those who hold them. Grant us grace to follow our Lord in the way of the cross, so that joined to his death and resurrection, we enter into life with you through the same Jesus Christ who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen. Okay. Come on, Richard.
All glory.
God, in your endless love for the human race, you sent our Lord Jesus Christ to take on our nature and to suffer death on the cross. In your mercy, enable us to share in his obedience to your will and in the glorious victory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. You may be seated.
A reading from Philippians. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Christ humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross. Therefore, God holds him and gave him the name that is above all names.
The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark. It was 2 days before the Passover and the festival of unleavened bread. The chief priests and the scribes were looking for a way to arrest Jesus by stealth and kill him.
For they said, not during the festival, for they may be a riot among the people.
Then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray Jesus to them.
When they heard it, they were greatly pleased and promised to give him money.
So Judas began to look for an opportunity to betray Jesus. On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb is sacrificed at evening, Jesus came with the 12. And when they had taken their places and were eating, Jesus said,
truly I tell you, one of you will betray me, the one who is eating with me.
they began to be addressed, and Satan, one after another, stormed them.
Jesus said to them, "It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the bowl with me. For the Son of Man goes as it is written of him. But woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born."
While they were eating, Jesus took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, gave it to them, and said,
"Take, this is my body."
Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, and all of them drank from it.
Jesus said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly, I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God."
When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives.
And Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered. But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee."
Peter said to them, "Even though all become deserters, I will not."
Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this day, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times.
But Peter said to him, "Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you."
And all of them said the same. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and
Jesus said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray."
He took with him Peter and James and John and began to be distressed and agitated.
And Jesus said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake."
And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that, if it were possible, the hour might pass from him.
He said, "Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I want, but what you want."
Jesus came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter,
"Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak."
And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him.
Jesus came a third time and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough! The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up. Let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand."
Immediately, while Jesus was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. And with him, there was a crowd with swords and clubs, from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders.
"Now betrayer has given them an offer, saying, 'The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away to the God.' So when he came, he went to Jesus our Father and said, 'Rabbi,' and kissed him."
Then they laid hands on Jesus and arrested him. But one of those who stood near drew his sword and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear.
Then Jesus said to them, "Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I was with you in the temple, teaching, and you did not arrest me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled.
All of them deserted him and fled. A certain young man was following him, wearing nothing but a linen cloth. They caught hold of him, but he left the linen cloth and ran off naked. They took Jesus to the high priest, and all the chief priests, the elders, and the scribes were assembled.
Peter followed him at a distance, right into the courtyard of the high priest. And he was sitting with the guards, warming himself at the fire.
Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none. For many gave false testimony against him, and their testimony did not agree.
Some stood up and gave false testimony against him, saying, "We heard him say, 'I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build it up.'"
But even on this point, their testimony did not agree.
Then the high priest stood up before them and asked Jesus, "Have you no answer? What is it that they testify against?"
But he was silent and did not answer.
Again the high priest answered, "Our Lord of God, Son of the Blessed One."
Jesus said, "I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and the coming with the clouds of heaven."
And the priest tore his clothes and said, "Why do you still need witnesses? You have heard the blasphemy. What is your decision?"
All of them condemned him as deserving death. Some began to spit on him, to blindfold him, and to strike him, saying to him, "Crucify." The guards also took him over and beat him. While Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the servant girls of the high priest came by. When she saw Peter warming himself, she stared at him and said,
"You also are Jesus, the man in Nazareth." But Peter denied her, saying, "I do not know and understand what you're talking about." And he went out and called.
Then the cock crowed.
And the servant girl man is one of them.
But again, he denied it.
Then after a little while, the bystanders again said to Jesus, "Certainly you are one of them, for you are a Galilean." But he began to curse and he swore an oath.
"I do not know this man that you are talking about." At that moment, the cock crowed for the second time. Then Peter remembered that Jesus had said to him, "Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times." And he broke down and wept. As soon as it was morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?"
"You say so."
Then the chief priests accused him of many things.
Pilate asked him again, "How do you know I am? See how many of you are and bring it into you." But Jesus made no further reply. So that Pilate was amazed.
Now, at the festival, he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone for whom they asked. Now, a name called Barabbas was in prison, and the rebels who had committed murder during the insurrection.
So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to present him before their time. Then he answered them, "Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?"
For he realized that it was out of jealousy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead.
Pilate spoke to them again, "Then what do you wish me to do with the man you call the king of the Jews?"
They shouted back, "Crucify him."
Pilate asked them, "What? What do you want to do?"
But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him." So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas to them, and after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified.
Were you crucify my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? So Christ, it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is, the governor's headquarters, and they called together the whole cohort. And they clothed him in a purple cloak. And after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him. They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down homage to him. They compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry his cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus.
Then they brought him to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull.
And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it.
And they crucified him, and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide what each should take.
It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." and with him they crucified two bandits, one on his right and one on his left.
Those who sat on my right, shaking their heads and saying, "Ah, you who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross."
In the same way, the chief priests, along with the scribes, were also mocking him among themselves and saying,
"He saved others. He cannot save himself. Let the Messiah, the King of Israel, come down from the cross now, so that we may see and believe."
Those who were crucified with him also taunted him.
"Were you there when the sun refused to shine? Were you there when the sun refused to shine?
When it was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. At 3:00, Jesus cried out with a loud voice,
"Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?"
When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "He's called."
And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying, Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now when the centurion, who stood facing Jesus, saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said,
"Truly this man was God's son."
Then Joseph bought a linen cloth, and taking down the body, wrapped it in the linen cloth and laid it in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock. He then rolled a stone against the door of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Jesus, saw where the body was laid. The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? To try.
victory.
Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the church, the world, and all in need. In Jesus, you came among us as a suffering servant. Give your church humility. Redeem your people from pride and the certainty that we always know your will. Heal us and empower us to confess Christ crucified. Hear us, O God. In creation, life springs from death. Redeem your creation awaiting resurrection. Restore lost habitats and endangered species. Create new possibilities for areas affected by climate change. Grant relief from natural disasters and nurture new growth. Hear us, O God. Jesus was handed over to the powers of this world. In all nations, instruct the powerful that they would not exploit their power, but maintain justice. Sustain soldiers and guide those who command them, that they serve those in greatest need. Hear us, O God. On the cross, Jesus joined all who feel forsaken. Abide with those who are condemned to death. Defend those who are falsely accused. Console and strengthen those who are mocked or bullied. Accompany all who suffer, especially Stephen, Mike, Karen, Roseanne, Bruce, John, Erna, Michael, Christina, Jackie, Steve, Elsie, Erin, Evelyn, Kathy, Philip, George, Mary, Charlie, Phoebe, Jimmy, Evelyn, Lynn, Eleanor, Kim, John, Betty, Mary, Judy, Wally, Marianne, Bill, Kathy, and those we name now before you, silently or loud. Grant respite and renewal. Hear us, O God. You called followers to tend Jesus' body in death. Sustain hospice workers and funeral directors. Bless this congregation's ministries at times of death, those who plan and lead funerals, those who prepare meals, all who offer support in grief. Hear us, O God. You inspired the centurion to confess Jesus as your son. We praise you for the faith you have given to people of all places and times. Give us also such faith to trust the promises of baptism, and with them to look for the resurrection of the dead. Hear us, O God. We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always, and also with you. Our stewardship thought for this week is teach us to die to self in service to others, that these waters may well up in us, an eternal fountain of unending joy. Let us pray. Please rise as you're able. Faithful God, you walk beside us in desert places, and you meet us in our hunger with bread from heaven. Accompany us in this meal, that we may pass over from death to life with Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who is present, who gives life, who calls into existence the things that do not exist. If you were to keep watch over our sins, O Lord, who could stand? Yet with you is forgiveness, and so we confess.
Gracious God, have mercy on us. You confess that we have turned away from you, no way has our own. We have honored you from your resurrection, God. We have betrayed you from your love for all people. Turn us back to you, O God. Give us new hearts and right spirits, that we may find what is pleasing to you and dwell in your house forever.
Receive good news. God turns to you in love. I will put my spirit in you, and you shall live, says our God. All your sin is forgiven in the name of Jesus Christ, who is free and abounding gift of God's grace for you.
I invite you to take out bread if you brought it from home. Otherwise, please come forward during our singing of Bind Us Together to get a wafer from the rail.
Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, Lord, bind us together in love. There is only one God. There is only one King. There is only one body. That is why we can sing. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together in cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, Lord, bind us together in love. You are the family of God. You are the promise divine. You are God's chosen desire. You are the glorious new wine. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, Lord, bind us together in love.
Holy, mighty, and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory now and forever. Gathered into one, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Jesus draws the whole world to himself. Come to this meal and be fed. Let us pray. God of steadfast love, at this table you gather your people into one body for the sake of the world. Send us in the power of your Spirit that our lives bear witness to the love that has made us new in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated for the announcement. So today is Palm Sunday, and we enter into Holy Week. For those of you that wish instructions on how to make a palm cross, there are some sheets detailing how to do that next to the palm. Please feel free to take one. We also have... just wanted to remind you that this week we have several services. On Wednesday, there will be no midweek Lenten service or Bible study. On Thursday, we meet here at 7:30 p.m. in the evening for a service of Holy Communion and the traditional stripping of the altar. On Friday, there will be the partially traditional crosswalk between Gloria Day and St. Peter's. This year we begin at Gloria Day at 12 noon and we'll process through the neighborhood, ending at St. Peter's, stopping along the way to say some of the various stations of the cross. For those of you that do not feel comfortable or cannot make noon time, this year for the first time there will be a Stations of the Cross in the parking lot. There will be 14 stations along the fence and perimeter of the parking lot. So feel free to walk that or drive it in your car. Spread the word. It's open to anyone in the neighborhood. There are seats out there, a long purple seat that has all 14 stations. This will be emailed home to everyone as well. But if you want a hard copy, it's outside for you to do your own Stations of the Cross anytime during the day that is good for you. In the evening at 7:30 p.m., we will gather here for a Tenebrae service. It's a service of readings and hymns for Good Friday. On Holy Saturday, we will join with our sisters and brothers of King and Kings and Gloria Day for an Easter Vigil at 7:30 p.m. at Gloria Day. Will be that service for this year. So please join us for that. And then Easter morning, we will be here for three services. Our first one is for the early risers, and for those who prefer an outdoor service, it will begin at 6:30 a.m., an Easter sunrise service, and it will be out there, weather permitting. We hope that God will provide us a beautiful day to celebrate the resurrection outside. So please spread the word to anyone that wants to join for that service outside. You can stay in your car or just stand distanced around on the lawn. At 8 o'clock and at 10 o'clock, there will be services inside the sanctuary. But we ask for those services that you make a reservation, because we have limits still on how many we can have in the building. So please make sure you contact the office, either calling and leaving a message, speaking to Jerry, or emailing, so that you can secure your place for that service. Following the 10 a.m. service, which will be more child-friendly, there will be an Easter egg hunt again, weather permitting. But the children will get Easter eggs, whether they hunt for them or they just get them in a bag. So we hope they will be able to hunt for them on the lawn. So please join us for any of those services. Spread the word to the community that all are welcome and that we are happy to be together this Easter. As you remember, last Easter we were just at the beginning of this pandemic and we had just an online service. So we are so thankful and blessed that we can be together. Even if it's not quite what we're used to, it will be a glorious and wonderful day. And we have some special musician things coming for you, some special musical selections. So please come join us. Speaking of our musicians, we would like to thank everyone that took part in today's service, especially the dramatic reading. We thank Jane and Paul for helping me read the passion story, and Leanne and John for singing our selections, and John and Lori, and Richard for providing our musical accompaniment. Thank you very much. And we thank our trumpeters, Tony and Karen, for bringing some beloved music back into this wonderful building. Are there any other announcements? Coffee hour will be on Zoom at 11:30 following today. Next week, there will be no coffee hour and there will be no Sunday school. So I invite you all to come and worship with your families and then enjoy, celebrate the day. So please rise as you're able. You are what God made you to be, created in Christ Jesus for good works, chosen as holy and beloved, free to serve your neighbor. God bless you, that you may be a blessing, in the name of the holy and life-giving Trinity.
Thank you. Thank you.